with thanksgiving. When you come to God and you bring your request to Him, amen, and you tell Him all about it, then the Bible says, give Him thanks. Somebody raise your hands and give us. Hallelujah. He said, by prayer and petition. Watch this. With thanksgiving. That means that when you pray and you ask God to bring an answer to that situation, go on and do something else. Once you pray about it, don't worry about it. Go on and get go shopping or something. Go buy some shoes. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Go do something else. He says, like, when you ask Him to do something, thank Him for it. And most of us, when we pray, we take our prayer to God and we ask Him over and over and over and over again. And God says, don't, when you pray about it, you don't have to keep praying about it. He says, thank Him for it. Even if you don't see the manifestation of your answer or the answer to the prayer, don't come back to Him and pray it again. He said, thank Him for it. Father, I thank You. I don't see the answer yet, Lord, but I know that You're working this situation out. God, I know, Father God, that it ain't manifested yet, but I know that You're a good God. God, I know that I did not receive what You wanted me, but I know, God, it is better to offer You. Somebody shout glory to God. Now, I learned how to give God praise in the midst of our situation. This. He said, when you pray about it and you bring that petition to Him, He said, once you pray, thank Him for it. Somebody say, thanksgiving. Present your request to God. Then He said, watch this, and the peace of God, verse 7, and the peace of God. Now, there's a difference between the peace of man and the peace of God. Okay? Because there is a peace from the soul, which you can call mind over matter. Yes. Amen. We talked a little bit about this on Wednesday. Amen. Where you try to tap into that human peace. Amen. But the peace of God is different. The peace of God will keep you strong in the midst of chaos, in a chaotic situation. Now, who am I talking to in here? Come on, somebody. Being at peace is considered by many to be healthy and the opposite of stress. So the peace of God, amen, when there's calamity going on around you, when you have tapped into God's joy and His peace, everything else can be going on, but you will not be affected. Yeah, everything else and everybody else can be affected. Come on, show me that now. But the Bible says you have a peace about you. When people will say, well, don't you know what's going on? Can't you see what just happened? Don't you, didn't you hear what they just said? You say, but the joy of the Lord is my strength. The ship of the disciples, and the Bible says that a storm came out of nowhere. That they was going, watch this, they was going to the other side, because before they got in the ship, Jesus already said, let us go to the other side. Yeah, that means that His word was already declared over the disciples that they was going to make it to the end. Hallelujah. But it's because a storm came. The Bible says Jesus was asleep in the ship, and the ship began to rock, and it began to rock, and it began to, amen, go side to side, and the Bible says that the disciples begin to panic. They begin to be worried. Jesus! 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 Don't you see that we get ready to perish? And the Bible says Jesus woke up and rebuked the storm. Watch this. Why did Jesus wake up with peace and just rebuke the storm? Because He already spoke out of His mouth that they was going to make it to the other side. Let me help somebody in here today. When God gives you a word, when He speaks over your life, when He prophesies and speaks to you, when you get a revelation in Scripture, no matter what goes on in your life, as long as you stand on the word of God, nothing can shake the word. Well, we learn how to put weight on the word. side. And I don't have more time to today, but God told me to tell y'all that if he spoke over your word, that he's able to perform the word over your life. Somebody put your hands together and give God some praise. Somebody put your hands together and give God some praise. And it will guard your heart. Somebody say, guard your heart.
Guard
your mind in Christ Jesus. Yeah. When God's peace is on you, amen, nothing can penetrate your heart. And when your heart is going up and down, side to side, you're angry 1 minute, peaceful 1 minute, happy 1 minute, sad 1 minute, upset 1 minute. Come on, somebody. That means that your heart is all over the place. Because you're letting things and people into that place that's supposed to be housed by the peace of God. Come on, somebody shout it, man. Somebody shout, I got God's peace. Hallelujah. Let me give y'all an example. The Bible says, watch this, which transcends all understanding. People don't understand how God's peace operate. They don't understand how God's peace operate. Yeah, because God's peace is different. His ways are not our ways, and his thoughts are not our thoughts. Are y'all hearing me? Watch this.